sequence in general. Gas coolants were having, liquid coolants were having, liquid solid combination you are having. Three different types of coolants are using. The gases means you are using hydrogen as well as carbon dioxide. Generally, in oxygen also we can use it. Liquids means we are using H2O and D2O, we can use liquid materials. So liquid solids is nothing but sodium. We are using liquid solid materials. Out of these three materials, we are using the nuclear power station. Sodium coolants we are using in this. The purpose of we are using the sodium, the cooling materials means this sodium cooling material we are having. High boiling point, low melting point. Due to we are having high boiling point, low melting point, that's what reason we are using sodium rather than these three coolants in this. So it means it will go and collect the heat. Okay, it will having high boiling point. Okay, easily it's boil it is. Okay, let's tune back to this. It keep on going under. So you are using liquid solid sodium coolants we are using. So the coolants continuously rotating like this, collect the heat from the nuclear reactor, giving back to this. So this amount of heat, heat the water, automatically the water will generate, converted into the steam by using the hot, then go back to the steam into the turbine. So your flow will go, the things will go here to the steam. Steam will go to the turbine. I hope you are understanding. So next we will have to go for the steam turbines. Heat exchanger we have switched on to the steam turbines. Steam turbine. So what is the purpose of steam turbine? The turbine which will take the high pressure steam we are converting into the mechanical energy. That mechanical energy will give back to your generators. Back to the generators. What it will do the generators? The generator which will convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy, give back to electrical energy to the transmission lines to the transformers. So here the generator working over, we are generating electrical energy, give back to that further. So here important thing is that as like a thermal power station, the steam heating of your turbine, low pressure or medium pressure, high pressure turbine, after heating of steam, the high pressure steam we are converting into low pressure, low temperature steam, we are marked to the condenser. I think you know the what is the condenser process. The condenser which will condensate the low pressure steam completely sent to the water. The condenser will converting low pressure steam into the water by utilizing the help of a cooling towers. As the thermal power station, the cooling tower, water treatment chamber, everything is same. So by using cooling tower help, the condenser will condensate the complete low steam water into the water. The same water will send back to the circulating pump into the heat exchanger. So same process will keep on continuously going under. I hope you are understanding it is what's going to happen in it is. Same water will keep on going under. So heat will generate the nuclear reactor to the chain reaction. That heat transferred to the heat exchanger via coolants. After that, the steam is generated by using of water. The steam converted, turbine converted high pressure to mechanical, mechanical to electrical by the generator, condenser process is going on there. In such a way, we are generating the nuclear energy in the fuels converted into electrical energy. I hope you are understanding. In this, there are two important points we are using. There is the reflectors. Here, the purpose of reflectors means what? The reflectors you are keeping inside the, this like a wall, the thick wall here, this is a reflector model. This is what a reflector lying inside the nuclear reactor core. The purpose of reflector means what? So I should try to understand very clearly. The reflector, which are very important examinations. Reflectors. The purpose of reflector means what? The moment the moderator and controller's operation will take place, In the chain reaction cases, we are generating n number of neutrons. The excess neutrons will generate. That neutrons, there may be chances will go from nuclear reactor core to out of the environment. The excess number of neutrons, what is the neutrons generated in the chain reaction, will move from the nuclear reactor into the outside of the environment. To provide to return that excess electron going out into the nuclear reactor, we have to provide the reflectors. The reflector, what we do means the reflector which will control, which will pushing back those electrons will go out of the environment. So what it will do, reflector? It will bouncing back of excess neutrons in the nuclear reactor to nuclear reactor core. So it will bouncing back excess neutrons generated in nuclear reactor. And what is going the escaping of neutrons? It will bouncing back of escaping neutrons. It's better. Bouncing back escaping neutrons into the nuclear reactor core. So neutrons trying to escape it out, it will bouncing back to the nuclear reactor. That's what you are doing. Reflector. The purpose of reflectors is it will bouncing back the escaping neutrons into the nuclear reactor core. What type of material are you using reflectors? We are using generally carbon H2O D2O, which you can use is a corner of nuclear reactor will bouncing back. Okay. The last important thing is shielding. The purpose of shielding is purpose. The shielding means an outer cover in the complete nuclear reactor, which is having 2 to 3 meters concrete wall, which are making throughout the nuclear reactor. Why we should cover the shielding means the nuclear reactor we are generating radioactive materials like alpha, beta, gamma rays. If those rays will come into the environment, automatically environment which should be polluted. The human beings also get affected. To protecting your radioactive materials, we are providing outer covering shielding. The purpose of shielding is to protecting environment, to protecting environment from the radioactive materials from the nuclear reactor. So what type of material are you using the shielding? The questions will come in examination. We are using lead and iron, barium, steel. These four different types of material we are using. So steel or iron or barium or lead material inside it is, then followed by we have to make it a big concrete wall 2 to 3 times of. So we have to make it a concrete wall throughout your nuclear reactor core. In such a way, we cover the complete nuclear reactor. Automatically, we protect total things of a nuclear reactor from unwanted things coming out from the nuclear reactor. Next important thing, final conclusion, efficiency. The efficiency is nothing but output by input. In the nuclear reactor, efficiency is nothing but the ratio of electrical output to the ratio of the radioactive material giving input, nothing but thermal input giving to the nuclear reactor. Generally, the efficiency of nuclear reactor is approximately little less than that, or is approximately half thermal power station, nothing but 30% to 35% only. Why we are having the less efficiency of nuclear reactor means same thing, we are using more heat in the condensation process and other different process, we are going to lose the heat. That's what the efficiency means, less in thermal power station, the hydro power station. Next, we can clearly say that the nuclear power station is base load plants only. The nuclear reactor plants are only base load plants. It is not a peak load plant. That I was already discussed in the last classes. I hope you are understanding each and every block how they are working in the nuclear power station. Okay. Thanks for watching. Keep continuing watching.